Hello all, welcome to the Ancient Channel. In today's video, I will explain in this is smart relay from the Schneider Electric about the Z-keys. So Z-keys is used for navigate. As you can see, this all four keys in the gray color. So basically what we can do with these keys is navigate through the menu and as well make the programming by the buttons in the display. So there is other function that we can use this button as well, and it basically is used in our program, our application. So instead of use external button like I have here, for example, I have four external buttons here and I have only one connected. So basically, instead of use this external button, we can use this button directly in the smart relay. So the objective of this video is show how to use one of these keys here in our application and how to activate these Z buttons in our program. Okay, so let's see how is this status right now that we have here. So basically our smart relay is in running mode and the programming language is Ladder. One thing that is very important to emphasize is that the Z keys functions can be only used in our program when it's in the ladder functions. Means that is when it's other programming language is chosen, we cannot use this as a buttons for our application, our program, okay? So let's see what we have inside our program. Let's navigate. So first we need to press the green button and then we go to monitoring. So basically we have only one line with programmed. So basically, as you can see, we have I1 means that the first digital input in our controller. So this is first digital input is connected to this blue button. Basically what we have here, we have this red wire connecting to the positive of the power supply, the 24 volts, and then pass to this contact of this button and then goes to I1. So basically when I press I1, I have the activating of Q1. Basically Q1 is the first digital output here, okay? So this is program very simple. So our objective is replace this digital input of this button with the first Z key for the Z1 key button, okay? So first of all, let's see how it's working right now. Let's press the button. As you can see, we have this modification. If in the I1, we have some kind of reverse video as per the manual in the I1, and then we have Q1 as well activated, okay? So we can hear the sound of the relay activated and deactivated. So then we can realize that the program is working properly and the Q1 is activated by pressing of the button, the blue button here in I1, okay? So the first thing that we need to do for change the program is go back to the main menu, right? So here we can see as well, when I press I1, we have the Q1 activated. We have this reverse video where you have white goes to black in the numbers. And this is as well for the digital input that I press I1 and as well for Q1, the digital output, okay? So the basic thing that you need to do for change the program is go to the programming mode. To programming mode, we need to change the status of the smart relay. We need to change for run to stop. So we need to stop the program to change. Okay, so let's go to the menu and then let's select to stop the program. Then they will request for confirmation. Let's press yes. Then we can already see that we have the controller is in stop mode, okay? So when you go again for the menu, instead of monitoring, we have programming. So let's click the green button as well. So let's see that we can navigate through the Z key functions that have the arrows below. So we can navigate to the left, to the right, and up and down. So up and down will move for the other lines of the ladder logic that we can program. So basically what we need to do here is change the digital input to Z key, okay? So to do this, we need to press the white button. So then we have more options in the bottom of the display will appear. So basically we need to navigate between plus and minus, okay? Let's press minus, we have I lowercase, and then let's press again. Then we have Z uppercase, okay? So once is selected Z uppercase, I will move the cursor just to confirm that we have our Z function selected, then let's press okay. So once we complete, they will request for confirmation. If you want to confirm the changes, let's put yes, and then the programming is already completed. So basically, let's move to run mode and let's see what will happen. So basically, it's run mode. Let's try to press the button. As you can see, we have the activation of digital input, but however, the output doesn't change, okay? That's because we changed the function of this button here to this button here. So let's press Z1 and see what happened. So if we press, we can see that nothing happens. It's because we need to do one step more that we forgot to do, okay? So basically, let's go to run and stop function, because every time that we want to change some configuration, we need to stop the program. Okay, let's stop the program and then go again to the menu and goes to configuration, okay? So let's go to configuration and then we can find the third option is ZX keys. So this option will activate the function of the Z keys, okay? Let's change for yes. Okay, let's exit. Let's start the program again. So now we have the Z key already enabled. As you can see in the bottom of the display, we have the number displayed, the number 1. That means that this key have some functions in the program, okay? So now let's press the button and then we can see that we have the activation of the digital output, okay? So this is very simple. So if you want to, instead of use a physical button, outside that you consume some digital input, basically you can use these 4 keys inside in the smart relay. So very useful when you have some application that you want to activate directly by the smart relay, so you don't need to use the digital input. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoy the content. So subscribe to the channel for more video like this one. Thank you. See you soon.